Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the last and very interesting chapter of the unit reproduction, that is reproductive health. So before we study more about the reproductive health, first of all, we should know what is reproductive health. It is actually the state of physical, emotional, behavioral and social fitness for leading a reproductive life. According to WHO, a total well-being in all the aspects of reproduction, that is physical, emotional, behavioral and social, is known as reproductive health. Now we will study about the various problems and the strategies to overcome those problems which are related to the topic reproductive health. So first of all, we will study about the problems that are related to the reproductive health. There is a very little knowledge about the personal hygiene and the hygiene of reproductive organs. This little knowledge causes a sexually transmitted disease or enhance the chances of sexually transmitted disease, which usually transfer from one partner to another at the time of sexual intercourse. Next problem is the early marriages or the custom of early marriages, which lead to the high maternal and infant mortality rate because at very early age the female body is not ready to bear a child. Next problem is lack of awareness, and due to the lack of awareness there has been a rapid increase in the population size. Another very common problem is people encourage beliefs in myths and misconceptions which are related to the sex related issues. So these are the various problems which we are dealing in the field of reproductive health. Now we will study about the various strategies or the steps which already has been taken to overcome these problems, or we are right now taking these strategies to solve the problem related to the reproductive health. So first strategy is the family planning programs, which were initiated as early as in 1951. Another is the Reproductive and Child Health Care RCH program, which were launched in 1997. These programs are responsible for creating awareness among the people about various reproduction related issues. Secondly, these programs are also providing the facility and support for building up a reproductively healthy society. Another strategy is with the help of audiovisual aids and print media, both government and non-government organizations are engaged in creating awareness among the people about the various reproduction related issues. Sex education is also introduced into the school curriculum to give the right information to the young minds and to save them from myths and misconception about the sex related aspect. Proper information about reproductive organs, adolescents, related changes, safe and hygienic sexual practices and STD, sexually transmitted diseases, should also be given for the maintenance of reproductively healthy society. It is very essential to educate the people about the various birth control options, care for the pregnant mother, postnatal care of the mother and child, importance of breastfeeding, equal opportunities for male and female child also. Another is to create awareness of the problems which can increase due to the uncontrolled growth of population, such as sex abuse and the sex related crimes. Last strategy, but the very important strategy, is the statutory ban on amniocentesis for the sex determination to legally stop the increase, to legally stop increasing the female feticide or death of the female child. Amniocentesis is basically a fetal sex determination test which is based on the chromosome pattern in the cells found in the amniotic fluid surrounding the developing embryo. So what we do in this particular type of test, we take the amniotic fluid which is around the developing nucleus and study the chromosomal pattern of that particular amniotic fluid or the chromosome which are present in the amniotic fluid, by which we can come to know that the developing embryo is female or male, and this is a major cause of female feticide. Because as people know that the developing embryo is female, they kill the child in the mother womb only. Population explosion and birth control. The increase in size and growth of human population is called population explosion. Indian population has reached 350 million at the time of independence and crossed 1 billion in the May 2000. This alarming growth rate of population may lead to the scarcity of the basic requirement, that is food, shelter and clothing for living organism. Here are some reasons for the high population explosion. First is decline in the death rate or the mortality rate, longer lifespan of an individual, decline in the maternal mortality rate or death rate of a mother at the time of delivery, decline in the infant mortality rate or the death rate of the infant child. Some religious belief against birth control, that we should not use the birth control. Lack of reproductive health knowledge, because earlier it was not there as a part of curriculum, so people are not aware about the reproductive health and they don't even take the topic of reproductive health very seriously and very openly they do not discuss.